And a good morning to you. Welcome back outside. As we had yesterday morning, a couple of spotty showers pushing through the region. Let's go right to the radar and you'll see it, and we'll put this in motion, moving in from the south, almost due north. These showers are moving, and maybe a couple of rumbles of thunder as these showers push through the area. Where they're happening, well, you can see that junction of Interstate 59 and Interstate 10. You can see right here, there's North Slidell. So just on the west side of Interstate 10, a little bit further toward the north, you see right around Hoswood and then Morgan Bluff, a little bit to the north there. And then further moving toward the north, right around the Bogalusa area and Crossroads, we're seeing right in between, seeing a little more rainfall. Again, it's going to be some moderate, maybe at times heavy rainfall. And this is going to be nearing Diamond Head. There's Interstate 10. So those are the areas where we're seeing some rainfall right now. I think throughout the morning we'll see these showers continue pushing through the region. Temperature-wise, mid to upper 70s on the North Shore, lower 80s along the Mississippi Gulf Coast. Of course, these are your current temperatures. And we're in the upper 70s to lower 80s south of Lake Pontchartrain. So let's talk and take a look at your exact cast headlines. Unfortunately, the models have changed pretty drastically. It's going to be a wet weekend. We thought maybe we'd dry out nicely on Sunday. I don't think that's going to happen, or doesn't look like it's going to happen right now. It's all because of this cold front and what's going on in the upper levels. And we're going to have to pay attention to the weather during the weekend, because we are going to see some locally heavy rainfall and the possibility for some localized street flooding. National Weather Service is going to be thinking about the possibility, as well as issuing maybe a flash flood advisory or some sort of watch as we head into the weekend. So you'll have to pay attention to the weather. This system right here, probably not going to become anything, maybe a subtropical system. It's a hybrid between a regular area of low pressure and a tropical area of low pressure. That'll keep on moving and staying in the Atlantic. And now, I'm not so concerned about this. Yesterday, we were looking at a whopping 70% chance of tropical development. Now, this is back down to 30% chance, which is a still medium chance. This continues tracking toward the west. This is really not going to be a problem for us, although it is going to help our rain chances over the weekend. The moisture down here is going to be drawn northward as we track the cold front. And you can see our front situated in this general area right here. This is what's heading our way. Out ahead of that, we've got a little surface feature, what we call a surface trough, that has developed, and this area of high pressure is going to push this through. Now, whereas where we thought the front was going to move through the area, and I guess maybe we got ahead of ourselves. First of all, rain chances today at 40%, similar to what we saw yesterday, is what we can expect today. Some spotty showers are going to be possible overnight tonight. Those football games, those high school football games, might get a couple sprinkles or two. Then we're looking at some coastal showers tomorrow morning. And here's our front back here. Rain chances are big tomorrow, 80%. Now, that doesn't mean it's going to be a total raining all day long. It'll be on again, off again, but 80%, that's the coverage as well. Everyone's going to see some rainfall for the most part. And look how heavy and nasty some of this rainfall is. This is 1 o'clock Sunday night. Now, if you're going to the LSU game, bring the poncho, because you're probably going to get some wet weather. You can see what's going on. Baton Rouge situated right here. This, of course, will be overnight, but even during the game, we could see some of that rainfall. And this area of low pressure, that's why we're going to stay wet pretty much all weekend as this area of low pressure develops. This is not going to be a tropical low. This is a response to what's going on in the upper levels. And notice what happens to our front. It gets hung up across the region. So if you're tailgating for the Saints game on Sunday, probably going to need a poncho there too, and the rain just kind of sticks around all weekend long. Notice we're going to look at about 2 to 4 inches of rainfall from today through about Monday afternoon, and unfortunately, the rain sticks with us Monday and even into Tuesday. Highs today, upper to the lower 90s, rain chances at 40%. Even today, we are looking at the possibility of some of that heavy rainfall. Mid to upper 70s overnight tonight, rain chances at 30%. Notice, whereas we thought we were going to be drying out as we hit Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, not so much. Rain stays in the forecast, and Sunday, of course, is the first day of fall, and it looks like fall is going to be brought in with a lot of wet weather. As you look at weather, Sala, back to you.
All right, Jay.